Alright, hey everyone, Wanderbot here, and welcome to Star Ocean Integrity and Faithlessness. So, this is going to be kind of a weird thing. This game got terrible reviews. I seem to be picking up games with generally meh reviews overall this past month, and this one really has not gotten a whole lot of... Okay, good. This one really hasn't gotten a whole lot of... I guess acclaim. It's sitting at about 6 out of 10s across the board. And is actually panned as quite possibly one of the shortest JRPGs of the year. Apparently it's only like 20 hours long, which is still pretty substantial, all things considered. But still, it's kind of long. Okay, I just want to quickly make sure everything character voices. I have no idea if that's in or... I don't know if that's in battle or out of battle. We might actually have to mess around with that one. Anyway, manual, semi-automatic. I have no idea. Mini-map display on. I just want to see all these options and stuff. But yeah, suffice to say, this game doesn't exactly have the greatest of reviews. Now, what might happen, and this is just a forewarning, is if this game is mediocre and I'm not feeling enough that I can complete it on my own, Shell is going to be here, my fiance who loves JRPGs. She will be here in a matter of days, so if it turns out that I can't continue on with this game, I will pause the series, catch her up. I'll probably just throw up like a really long episode where we catch up to where I am in the story, and then we'll go on from there. But I don't know yet. Anyway, let's get started. Let's see. Galaxy. Mode is standard level difficulty. Earth, easy. Okay, let's just go Galaxy. I've heard this game isn't particularly hard either. Alright, would I like to undergo the battle tutorial? Yeah, I guess. Last Star Ocean game I played was back on the PS2. So, pushing L in a certain direction allows your character to move that way. Dash holding down circle, walk holding down square. You cannot hover walk during battles. Change the camera angle using R. Press down R3 to reset the camera angle. That probably also locks you on. Let's see. Square or circle quickly during battle to attack the enemy you're currently targeting. X is weak attack, circle strong attack. Information will show up on the display. Next page. Attacking. Depending on your character's distance from the target, his or her attack will automatically change to close quarters or long range combat, denoted by the shorter long icon in the upper left corner. Okay, when multiple valid targets exist, and your targeting type is set to manual, you can either press L1 or R1 to switch between targets. I can also switch simultaneously to select between the nearest target. If I'm at semi-auto, it'll automatically switch to the enemy nearest to me. You may also lock onto targets by holding down either L1 or R1. The targeting type is set to manual by default. Got it. Okay. How do I target? How do I, like, actually... I mean, this is my target. Oh, I see. My character will automatically move forward to attack. I see, so it's less... It's a little bit less action-y than I thought it was going to be. Animations aren't bad. Visual style is pretty good. Attack affinities. The interplay between weak attacks, strong attacks, and guarding is similar to rock, paper, scissors. Weak attacks can interrupt strong attacks. Strong attacks can break enemies' guards. Guarding can stop weak attacks and lead to counterattacks. Before affinities... Or before enemies unleash strong attacks, an aura will appear around them. Once you see this, a weak attack to disrupt the attack. Got it. A counterattack. Press square at the right time after guarding against a weak attack to launch a counterattack against the enemy. Not only will a counterattack launch your foe, but it also causes it to flinch and interrupt whatever action it was about to perform. Try to launch counterattacks as much as possible and make battles easier. Yeah, wanna... Okay, hold on. Okay, so I hold this. Oh, and he did a heart attack. Okay, battle skills are powerful abilities that may be used By spending MP, there are two categories, Special Arts and Signaturgy. Signaturgy is sorceress, well, Special Arts are physical. Hold down X or Circle to target an enemy you're targeting with the skill you equip to that button. The battle skill mapped to X will be a weaker attack or something heavier. Both, however, are hidden behind, beholden to attack affinities. As strong attacks inflict more damage than weak ones, they also cost more MP to use. As a note, Signaturgy that does not deal damage will not increase in potency, even if mapped to a strong attack button. You may map battle skills in the battle skills menu. There are four battle skills that may be set together in any combination. They include short range, weak attacks, short range, strong attacks, long range, weak attack, long range, strong attack. Battle skills, yeah, got it. Okay. Double slash. Seriously? That's also double slash. This guy's name is Ted that I'm hitting. That's quite the name. And by quite the name, I mean not.
Huh. I'd say that should about do it for training. How about we take a lap around the village? Five whole years have passed since you took over for your father. So much has changed in that time.
You think so?
What's more, the capital's supposedly a real scary place now. Word is, the people slain by monsters and bandits are innumerable.
So I've heard.
It's all so different. I hope your dad's okay.
Trust me, you don't need to worry about him.
We've been able to turn a blind eye to these atrocities so far, but how long until Stahl is attacked?
Let's play spot that main character. I wonder who, with the colorful jacket and weird straps. Okay, which way do I go? I'm going to assume this direction. I actually like this game.
Doesn't that look like Miki to you?
Miki?
Is Miki really 18 already? She looks way more mature than I did at her age.
I don't know. I've always considered her a little sister. I can only think of her as a kid. Let's see what she's up to.
You mean you haven't seen this girl in a short period of time? In a while? I have no idea. Anyway, I just wanted to say, I actually like this game's, like, environment art. Too many JRPGs lately have had, like, really boring and or, like, totally shitty environments. Like, looking at you, Tokyo Mirage Sessions with the ultra-boring, generic Japan. I mean, the, like, dungeons ain't so bad, but still. But this one actually, like, attempts to at least, you know, make things look nice, even if it is a little bit polygonal. Anyway, a mini-map displays everything, just the size by pressing gotcha. To view the full map in an area, press the options button. Take note that you will not be able to view this map in every area. Moreover, you will not be able to move while the map's open. Gotcha. Okay. Well, I guess it's... How old is this character supposed to be?
What's going on?
I thought I saw some people off in the distance.
Some people?
I assume so. And I was curious since everyone's saying how dangerous things are now. Right there.
Whoa! No way! Your suspicions were right.
Talk about being fishy.
There's no way anyone could mistake them for stallions.
What do we do? Do you have any ideas?
Let's go to the mayor and think of a plan together.
Come on! You're okay with letting them go?
They'll just run away if we try to capture them. So what's the point? Don't you think it'd be better to prepare for an attack?
You're the heir to the Camus School of Swordsmanship, all right. You have the commander's instincts of your dad.
I've already forgotten. What is his name? Tom? Tim? Todd? I don't remember. Anyway. Oh, wow, yeah, I can actually run faster there. I will take it. Now I'm just kind of... Loading screens are... Always hard to deal with.
Pardon me if I find your tale of enemy scouts a little hard to swallow.
I'm not lying.
So, who is it you think we're dealing with?
Adelon.
Adelon? You mean those vile bandits who are more monsters than men?
In reality, they're a veritable natural disaster. They're so destructive that 5 years ago, my dad was asked to travel the country. Why? To specifically teach locals how to defend themselves against these degenerates.
We're done for! How could we ever hope to do anything against those savages?
Mr. Mayor.
But this is all too far over my head. I don't know the first thing about fighting.
Mr. Mayor! Please, calm down. You're this village's leader. You have to be its proverbial rock. I'll be the one to lead our people in battle.
But Fiddly!
Well, it's not like anyone else is stepping forward. Might as well be him.
I beg you, Fidel, please deliver our home from certain doom.
I'll give it everything I've got.
They really have not introduced any of these characters apart from they fight. There's a girl that's kind of a sister figure who's apparently also 18 that calls Fidel, the main character who we just discovered, Fiddly. Yeah, I can see why this game's gotten kind of panned by the reviews, which is a bit rough. Because, like,
Do you think they'll actually attack us?
I actually like a lot of these, like, bits here and there. I'm gonna go inside this house for arbitrary reasons. You know, I actually like the fact that all the cutscenes are... Oh, great. Save points. I do so love them. Okay. Oh, they glow red during cutscenes. Let's see. Loading save data. Gotcha. Well, we might as well save. So, I will actually admit, I like the fact that a lot of the, like... walking and talking is rendered in-engine. I kind of wish it was a bit smoother, like the characters would move to an area and like get in position and then it would give you an actual camera angle. It's a little awkward, like for that one especially, that we get to the end of the loading screen and more or less immediately dumps us into dialogue halfway through, which is really weird.
Actually attack us?
Where am I even going here? Oh yeah, we can... No, that's not useful. Okay, you know, I wish they paced this out a little bit better. Because, yeah, loading screen ends is like, do you think I will believe your story? It's like, whoa, I didn't even tell you the story. When did this happen? Guess I just, like, passed out for a bit.
I'm about to pull my hair out from all this stupid waiting.
Really? Why?
All the men are thinking the same thing. If no one attacks, then we're the ones that are going to pay.
Still, I'd say that's preferable to getting raided.
Think we can hold out?
Maybe once at most. Depending on their numbers.
Once at most?
Yes. Both the men and the village itself would be hurting by the second time.
What'll we do?
We'll ask the capital for reinforcements. Either way, let's not get ahead of ourselves.
Here.
Take the women and kids to the training hall.
Gotcha.
Fellow townsmen, prepare for battle!
Say your prayers!
Oh, shit.
What?
Did I have a dodge there, or am I just... I'm very confused. I thought for a second I did, like, a dodge. But I guess not? I might actually switch to this time automatic out of just sheer curiosity. I don't mind... I don't know. I'm still kind of in the middle of, like, review mode here. Let's see. How much MP do I have? Plenty. There we go. Okay. Looking forward to having a full party here to support me with attacks, mainly heals. Yep, she's just our generic healing character.
Head for the training hall. That's where everyone is.
No, I'm going where you go. No pains, hands, or butts.
Your head always gets a lot bigger when we're alone. Whatever. Do what you will.
Okay, so the combat system's pretty basic. Kind of wish it was a little bit more action-y, like, well, he said something, but I did not hear it. Maybe there was nothing. Maybe we go this way and there's, like, another engagement. Nope, never mind. Probably check map. Check map means nothing to me. Okay! Well, that's not useful. So you just got a bunch of random guardsmen milling about with me.
I can't take this! Fidel, it's you!
My duties lie elsewhere. Keep hidden until this all blows over.
I'm not a mayor, I'm a cow.
Soon you could be those kids' hero.
I can't take this!
Yeah, there are definitely some issues here and there. This is also, like, hella dark. Where the devil do I go? I guess we go down this way. There's no star on the map, so... Nope. Oh, shit. Thought it... Yep, their number's down there. There was... no indication that they're back the way I came. What? Alright, whatever. I guess I can sprint here, go faster, maybe? Does that actually... Oh yeah, that does actually make me go faster. That is kind of an important note along the way. Okay. But yeah, I don't mind the combat so much. It's like pretty basic action combat. The combos work. I wish there was an active dodge, just because, you know, with this kind of game, an active dodge makes sense. Don't worry. You go find somewhere that's short on numbers. Okay. Apparently I got a bonus for 30-second victory. Not entirely sure of that. I wish the enemies had a little bit of a, I wish the enemies had a little bit of a, what is it? What, finished? Oh.
You're hightailing it out of here!
Yes! We did it! We won!
Did we win?
Okay.
Yeah. Somehow.
I got blueberries from the bandits. I'm not really sure how or why. And Mickey leaves the party. No! She'll be back.
The village lives to see another day.
Thank you ever so much for all you've done for us.
We may have fended them off for now, but who knows what'll happen next time.
Next time? You're saying they might come again?
I think so.
Please tell me that's not true.
So, what's next? If I know you, I take it you have some kind of plan?
We'll ask the king for more troops.
More troops? A splendid idea.
I'll depart at once. I guess I won't be hearing any more of your quips for a while.
That make you sad?
More like relieved.
Damn, you're cold. Come back in one piece.
I will. And in time, too. Take care of Stahl for me, will you?
Done and done.
See ya, nerd. This is the wrong way. I think. I actually have no idea which direction I'm going. Let's see, there's a training hall, infirmary, mayor's house. Ah, that's where we're going. Okay. So yeah, that combat was not exactly the most impressive, and the pacing for this beginning is really, really off. Like, usually they spend at least half an hour kind of laying the framework for the plot, you know, introducing the characters. All I know is that my dad's super famous. I've got a cool blue hoodie that it looks pretty slick, actually. Character designs in this across the board are pretty good. Like, even this old guy actually looks damn cool. I mean, wish there was maybe a bit more fidelity in that face, but then again, how often are we actually going to see close-ups of old man face here? A lot of the NPCs are actually completely unique. I haven't seen any repeated characters yet.
I hope you know I'm coming along.
Huh?
To the capital, with you.
Don't be stupid, Miki. Go on home.
Hey, wait a minute. Don't you understand how dangerous it'll be?
That's exactly why I'm going. You could barely handle things last night. I could never let you go alone.
Don't be selfish.
And if I somehow do get in trouble, I know you'll save me from it.
Really, Miki?
If you won't take me with you, I'll go by myself. Maybe I'll get captured by sleazy bandits. Maybe I'll get attacked by savage beasts. But I'm still going. End of discussion.
See if I care. Okay, you've made your point. Take you with me.
Yes!
Under the condition that you make sure to stick by my side.
Okay.
Okay, changing characters. You can switch between characters during battle with left and right. Once I change characters, the one I previously was controlling will perform actions automatically in accordance with the game's AI. Roles can be set for each individual, and then the roles the characters play in the party affect the attributes and how they act during battle. You can make battles much easier by setting roles that play off each other, and you may set up for up to 4 roles per character. Please note the potency of certain role-specific factors may vary, depending on the role, even if the effect is the same. You can change characters' roles from the Set Roles submenu under the Roles section of the main menu. You can set a particular role for any character once you learn it, but only one character may use that role at a time. When you set a role for one character that is already in use on another, the role will automatically be removed from the previous character. Okay, pressing triangle during battle will bring up the battle menu, which contains various options that will aid you in your martial endeavors. As long as you have the battle menu open, the battle will pause. That's good. Access the following submenus: Signaturgy, Spells, Items, Roles, Set Battle Skills, Equipment, And it's possible to change what character you control during the battle, while having the battle menu open. Use this option when you wish to change without feeling rushed. And hold up to 20 of a given usable item at a time. All weapons, armor, accessories, valuables are unique, however, and thus you can only possess one of each at a time. As for any other items, you may carry up to 99 of each. Anytime you obtain an item of which you already possess the number allotted, it is immediately discarded. Moreover, you may possess up to 999 items in each category. In the event you acquire items that would put you over the category limit, you will be asked to choose ones from your inventory to discard. Finally, please remember that you will lose any items that exceed these limits. If you close the main menu, load save data, or quit the game before making room for them in your inventory. Gotcha. Signature Liturgy is a type of battle skill, allows you to cast spells. Only certain characters can use it. Fidel cannot. Let's see. As with special arts, you can assist cast Signature Liturgy holding down X or Circle. Beware, however, that you may only map spells that target enemies to these buttons. Unlike special arts, though, you can also open the battle menu and use them. Okay. By selecting the battle skills from the battle menu, you can set which ones. Gotcha. Okay, let's do that quick. Roles. Set roles. We have attacker, and we have healer. So there's a role level, and mastery, and tactics. And so as you level them up, you get extra things. Gotcha! Makes sense? I'm not gonna touch that for a long time. Hello, blueberry lady. Okay, let's see. So we can purchase blueberries, 30% HP, 30% MP, revive, recover, some HP. How much money do I have? An amount. Let's buy, like, 2 fresh sage. Oh, wait, no, apparently I have 5 of them. Whoops. What about, how many blueberries do I have? 11 blueberries, 11 blackberries. No mint, that's poison paralysis. Raw fish, shellfish meat. So there's a cooking system in this game. I'm gonna ignore it. I think I saw equipment merchants up here, and I, you know, if I'm carrying around a healer, that's probably going to be good enough for me.
Sorry.
Oh, really? Bumping into somebody, I will actually apologize to them and they'll react. To be fair, I'm phasing directly through her, which is, I'm a dick, but whatever. Okay, armorer. I would like to buy your finest of longswords. Is this better than the one I have? Compare. Confirm. Okay. Fidel's... How do I know what? Okay, compare. Confirm. I'll buy it anyway. I'm just going to assume it's good. I see. It has an equal sign, saying that's what we already have. I get it now. Well, I feel stupid. Okay, because if I check this, we can check equipment. So if we go back to him... Yeah, we already had a longsword. Whoops. I thought they said that, longswords were unique. I guess that's a lie. Alright, never mind. Not like it really matters too much, but still. Yeah, I like a lot of the ideas that go into this game. I just feel like the execution might be a little bit on the rushed side of things. They're like, okay. Anyway, skill points denoted by the crystal icon in the form of currency required to learn and hone specialities and roles. They are acquired at the end of battles. As specialties and roles are integral to adventuring on Faycreed, it is in your best interest to increase their benefits by actively expending skill points. View how many skill points you have accrued, look at the top right. Okay, gotcha. Learning and honing roles. You can unlock new roles by having new members join your party, progressing in the story, or leveling up certain other roles. Simply unlocking a role, however, does not allow you to use it. You must first expend the requisite number of skill points to learn it. Roles active at the conclusion of a battle become honed, and they level up after a certain amount of honing. In addition, you may level up roles by expending skill points. Gotcha. Specialties are skills that give your party advantages not necessarily associated with battle. For example, some allow you to acquire certain items, while others give you more information on the minimap. They can be unlocked in various methods. You can view the party's specialties and level them up. And the specialties menu under the skills section of the main menu. Although most specialties are passive and take effect immediately upon learning them, press square while in the aforementioned menu to use the ones that must be activated manually. Harvesting. Green. Plants and fruit. Yellow. Ore. Blue. Fishing. Well, I like these, like, little drawings here. They're cute. Okay, well harvesting specialty allows you to harvest from certain locations. You must learn the excavation and fishing ones as well if you were to identify and harvest from all possible locations in the world. You can learn harvesting right away as long as you have the SP, but you cannot unlock excavation and fishing until you progress in the game. Finally, the higher these specialties levels, the more you can gather. Bah. Okay, let's go take a look at skills. Let's... specialties. We might as well learn... we can't. I'll have to go beat the shit out of some things. I don't mind this environment so far. It's good, the music's good. I'm actually fairly okay with the voice acting. Mickey's might get a little annoying for me, but maybe that's just me, I don't know. It'll take a while before I get used to it. The art and design of this game, overall, actually has left me pretty impressed. But yeah, I think really this game just was a rush job. They're actually working on two Star Ocean games. I don't know when the other one's coming out, but it's a remake of a previous one. I honestly don't know which specifically, but, counters. Once you either attack or are attacked by enemies while exploring, you'll have encountered them and enter battle. To attack and initiate a battle, make sure the enemy has its target cursor over its head. Go up to that. If you strike before any enemies notice, it will be considered a preemptive attack. Gotcha. If any enemies attack you to initiate the counter, you'll be considered a surprise attack and everyone in the party will have their physical defense reduced for a short period of time during that battle. Battles will end once you have eliminated all the enemies, and that time you will receive an amount of experience and rewards based on your performance. Experience full SP, gotcha. Okay, escaping by moving your character outside of the ring. Got it. Once the gauge fills, you leave. You don't get any experience or full for it. Got it. If any enemies are killed during the battle, they will respawn, so be on your guard after you escape. Occasionally, battle perimeter will be red instead of blue. You can't run away. Gotcha! These tutorials are starting to become a bit of a problem. I'm glad that I can read them at my own pace. Oh. I have no idea. Oh. So double slash actually is bound to both of them, and it knocks enemies around. I like that. Anyway. I like the fact that the battles are seamless. I hate games where, oh god, those are horrifying looking. I hate games where, like, it takes a long time to load in and out of battle. That's always a bit of an issue for me. It's boring. I don't want to have to wait, for, like, a random encounter. I'm looking at you, I guess Pokemon, really, has always been particularly, criminal in terms of, like, long loading screens associated with. Okay, character voices I might have to turn off. I do like the, I do like the fact that there is banter back and forth between the characters, but it's meaningless, and since there's no, like, kind of, Tales of style, like, you know, cutesy, victory animation, it ends up just being background noise. At least the characters aren't, like, yammering too much all the time, but there is a fair amount of yammering. I do like the fact that a lot of my abilities, if placed correctly, can actually, let's see, can I get out of the way of that? Yep. Can actually, like, hit multiple targets. That's useful. I enjoy when, like, positioning actually matters. Okay, so, let's do skills, let's do specialties, learn harvesting, yes. Okay, so now we've got level up. I need 100 to level it up. I kind of wish harvesting would gain experience just like everything else, but it looks like everything is tied to skill points. But now we've got herbs that I can collect from, and they show up on the map. That's nice. I hate the alternatives. Oh! Oh! Okay, so you know how I was complaining about herbs, not leveling up on their own? Or my gathering herbalism, whatever you want to call it? Turns out, actually, I get a little bit of... really? Can you at least tell me why I can't open it up? Nope, I guess it's locked and we have to wait until we find some kind of mystical magical key instead. I guess that's kind of understandable. Okay, let's go in here first. Yep, there's a treasure chest. Okay. But, as I was saying, there's actually another Star Ocean game in the works, which is a remake of a previous one, And I kind of feel like they split their budget, and that was a bad move. Because, I don't know. JRPGs, I feel like, should be... I'm gonna say labors of love, especially because, like, the last Star Ocean game to come out was, when did the last one come out? For the 360, I think. And I want to say it was, like, back in 2007? I want to say it's, like, 2007-ish. It was a while ago. And so for a lot of people, it's been a pretty long wait between Star Ocean games. And I actually didn't hear anything about the previous one. Preemptive attack. It did not work out in my favor here. I wonder how you get MP back. Maybe it's purely based on items. Though maybe I can... Ooh, that worked out. It might be entirely based on items, though I might, like, recover it out in the field or something. I don't know. Well, I have 31 now, so let's see if I get any... if I get any more between the next battle. It'd be pretty rough if we didn't get anything, but, eh, whatever. I mean, we can always just cram blackberries into our face, which actually isn't so bad. Oh, let's see. I don't know, I'm still kind of in review mode. I actually am liking this a fair amount. I'm still kind of on the wall about whether or not I'm just going to kind of hold out for Shell. Because I think this is the sort of thing that would actually be rather enjoyable with a second person. Especially for, like, the slow-mo modes. Because, I don't know. I just want to play a JRPG with her again. For those of you that don't know, I haven't been living with my fiancé for a while. And she loves JRPGs, and I was trying to get her to come here the week before now, so we could cover every single JRPG that came out, but instead I'm in this, like, kind of awkward part where, like, a JRPG comes out, and I'm like, so, now what? I guess I'll just start it, and if it seems worthwhile, I'll restart it? YouTubing is hard. Okay, so I've not regained any MP, however, I do regain health out of battle. Interesting. I wonder if there's like a combo meter. So, like, you can stack things. Like, you know, attack 1, attack 2, attack 3. If there's some kind of combo chain for that, or if it's just, like, standard attacks. I don't know. Anyway, I think I forgot to finish what I was saying earlier, because I'm easily distractible. But yeah, you actually gain a little bit of money and skill points for gathering in this game. So technically, harvesting does level itself up. It just uses the exact same limited resource as everything else in the game. Which actually seems like a totally fair thing to me. Okay, we should probably not stand in the center of that. Though... Okay, manual targeting is a little bit on the worrisome side. I also wish it was not as aggressive about stealing my camera and moving that around. It's a little stun-locky. I'm sure once I have a full party, this won't be so bad. But I am... Like, the problem is, since I can't dodge, there's not really a whole lot I could do. I guess... I just can sit here blocking and countering. You know, that's what I should probably do along the way. Finish five consecutive blows. I wonder if that actually matters for anything. It probably does. I just have to look into it. There's an interesting looking stone there that probably has no relevance to anything. Shame, but whatever. Also, like the area design, it's super linear, I will grant. It's, like, it is super linear. Which is definitely a problem. Oh. I can dash around enemies with the... Oh, never mind. That was guard break. Whoops. Yeah, I'll get used to the combo... the whole blocking system. It does seem like it's generally best to just sit around blocking half the random attacks getting thrown my way. See if that arcane bracelet gets me anything. Accessory 1, arcane bracelet. Well, I guess we might as well give it to her. Just because. Okay. Let me think. Rolls, learn rolls. Plant Slayer, Insect Slayer. So, 50 SP for both. Prioritize attacks on plant foes, damage to plants, damage from plants, yeah, okay. Doesn't look like I get any specific skill points for this. Oh, here. This is something. What are these? These are miscellaneous rules. Stamina Stockpiler. Convert your fighting spirit to stamina. Interesting. Doesn't look like I'll be able to do anything with that. Oh, right. The other thing to consider is attacker. Level up roll costs 95 SP. However, they will also do it automatically. Okay, so let's not do anything with that. Skills. Learn battle skills. Okay, double slash. We already have. Use skill? Upgrade skill. Oh, I see. I am super confused. Oh, you need a skill book to enhance a battle skill. Okay. I see. So, Swordman's Manual 2, Restorative Signets, Solar Signets. Gotcha. And I assume that resources, skills, specialties, we don't have anything else we can learn for the time being. Okay, well, let's not look at the user interface too long. Let's just... Actually, you know what? Before we go too much further, though there are those kind of insane-looking turtle things, let's see on the map. We're halfway to Minos. I think this is actually a pretty good stopping point, in a way. I'd say about half an hour in. Let's give our basic impressions of the game, even though, obviously, basic means we haven't seen the rest of it. So, I'm not really sure if all of the reviews, if this deserves all of the negativity getting thrown its way. I have definitely played worse games out there. I like the character designs for the most part, though it is a little bit weird trying to cram big anime eyes on slightly more realistic faces. Like, the faces feel a little wide for the way... Oh god, yeah, that is really weird, actually. They look like creepy doll people. Luckily, I will never see that for the most part, but yeah, looking at these people's eyes makes me uncomfortable. Just in the same way as Xenoblade, come to think of it. Xenoblade Chronicles X had the same problem where they're like, well, we really like the anime style, so we're gonna stick anime eyes on slightly more proportionate people. And it looks weird. Oh well. But, you know, I like the character designs, the voice acting ain't bad. The in-engine cutscenes are a little bit boring, but whatever. It's not terrible. It's just a bit on the lazy side of things. I can see my butt flaps are clipping through each other. I'd say I should judge that, but I don't know. I'm feeling in a kind of forgiving mood just because at least so far I'm interested. Obviously, we haven't run into these space people yet, and really haven't met any of the villains or anything like that. But at least from like core gameplay perspective, this actually doesn't seem so bad. But yeah, if it's only 20 hours long and features a fair amount of backtracking, I'm probably going to get a bit cranky at this game, which is what I've heard is like the main issue with the game, apart from being a little bit clunky in terms of dialogue and portrayal, which we've definitely already experienced. So would I say it's worth $60? No. I would say this game's probably worth more along the $20 mark, 20 to 30, depending on how much of a fan you are of JRPGs and a fan of, I guess, the Star Ocean series. Because it seems like it's got a lot of the elements, it seems like it's got a lot of promise, but they cut out half the game because of time and or budget constraints. Which is a darn shame, because I would actually like to play, you know, a 60-hour, $60 JRPG with, like, fully fleshed out everything. And I guess this isn't gonna quite cut it. Nuts. Oh well, either way, I guess that's pretty much it. So, I will see you guys on the next episode, but of course, before I go, if you guys like this episode slash sort of impressions video in any way, shape, or form, leave me a like, helps more than you know, and if you want to see more, hit subscribe, because I'm definitely going to do a full playthrough of it. Already shelled out the money, though there is a very real possibility I will get mildly annoyed at the game, put it on pause for a bit, and come back with a co-commentator. We'll see on that one. Either way, though, like I was saying, see you guys next time, and as always, thanks for watching.